Welcome back to Ukko Plays Hearthstone Arena. Here we are with our 2-1 mage deck. The one mage deck with very little fire spells, but let's keep going anyway. No fireballs, no flame strikes. Two polymorphs, at least. Two legendaries. Sadly, one of them is Maligos, who is kinda useless. I should have known that when I picked him, but oh well. You gotta pick Maligos at least once when you play as a mage. Alright, who do we get?
Jaina versus a druid. Malfurion.
Fighter named Druid. Interesting.
You asked for it.
Get my polymorph, but I don't really want it. And it's pretty fine. I need something more. Kind of a low level to play. Maybe turn 2 Acolyte of Pain could be good. Depending a bit on what he does, of course. Cultmaster is another a pretty nice card, so you kinda wanna get it out when you have other things on the board first. So, unless he plays something. I can't even think what he would play. Some sort of a thing with one health that I just need to be... that I just need to kill. Then I don't think I will. I mean, maybe if he plays Magma Rager, you know, Inner Wraith Magma Rager, isn't it? 3 mana card? Yeah?
I smell.
Can't do anything to that. So. Okay, pick my Maligos. Pull my Maligos. So next turn, probably. Well, I may also ping this guy down if he attacks with it. He may not actually attack with it. This is a nice dude to just keep in the. Stealth here and wait for the enemy player to play some sort of a bad card. Yeah, since he did nothing, I think I will in fact coin into this guy. As in, since he did nothing, since he did not play any more minions, he just used his hero power here. Alright, Worgen. That's actually kind of a nasty thing since I can't... Oh, Frostbolt. Based Frostbolt. Let's see, if I play Frostbolt I can't then... yeah, but I have to Frostbolt this. He can enrage it with this guy. So the only way out of it is to Frostbolt him. And just attack him with this dude then. And turn. Alright. Yeti comes out next. Funny how this guy is still in the... Okay, should not play this guy, as he'll just kill it first. I'm gonna pull this guy back. I'm gonna also just... I'm gonna play this guy and throw this guy at it. Throw the Acolyte at the Yeti, but that feels like a bit of a waste. I feel like Cobra may be the best play here. He will still get a decent trade with the Yeti though, since he can just kill this guy without losing anything. You know, pinging this guy and dropping something like the Ooze might actually be the best play here. To just, like, maximize the cards I get. Oh no, wish I had that before. Oh well. But Ooze can be killed by this dude. Is that guy even worth pulling back? Let's drop the Ooze and see if he just trades it with this guy. I think he will. It'll clear the board, but gonna cost me a higher cost minion. Still, I guess it's 1-to-1 trade in cards, if you put it like that. Okay. What will he do? Second Yeti comes out, that's kinda nasty. Yeah, he trades with that dude. I thought he would. And he leaves. Oh, that's actually pretty bad for him. If I drop this guy, then I can play Polymorph after that. And this is also something he definitely wants to kill, I would think.
What to do? What to do?
I mean, I have to sheep one of them. My greetings.
Hello.
I think I'll play this guy. Then I polymorph one of them, like this dude. And kill the sheep. Kill the sheep with this guy.
Job's done.
Alright, I get my own yeti. That was pretty optimal for me. And this guy is actually pretty useless since I don't have that many spells. He rats it down anyway. I'm happy that he wastes a rat on that dude. Alright. Alright. Options. I think Yeti is better than the Ogre Magi. He can just trade with the Ogre Magi. This dude would just die to his Yeti if I dropped it. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get my Yeti out then. And is there any reason I think I should just drop this guy? Actually, I should drop Yeti and pop this guy's bubble. Yeah. I think that's the way to go. I have plenty of cards, but they're all kinda like minions and... Well, I don't have that many spells anyway, so I guess the best thing I could hope would be my other polymorph. Well. At least he has less cards than me. I hope he doesn't have much card draw there. Okay, he's just gonna ignore my Yeti there. That's probably a smart thing to do. Okay, turn 7. Okay, arcane missiles. I could drop like this guy and then arcane missiles and then ping once more. Problem is he can just trade with this guy. Anything kills this guy. And if I drop this guy, he'll just kill it with the 3-3, I guess. If I drop the Ogre Magi, he has to trade with this guy. I'm gonna try the Ogre Magi and see what the arcane missiles hit. Maybe I get lucky. That's gonna... Well, that's fine. I mean, I can kill this guy at least here. Yeah. And he loses both of his cards if he wants to get rid of my dudes. I would think he wants to get rid of the spell power one at least. Oh, what's this? A swipe? Swipe would make sense. No moonfire, okay. Well, swipe would have been far worse. That's annoying. I can ping it down still, but it is still annoying. Okay, so question is, do I ping something down? Maybe drop this guy? Well, he can kill this guy, but I think I should just drop this guy since he is such a huge threat right now. So, ping this guy, that will leave me with 3 mana. Then I can just drop something like this dude, maybe. I can drop the Cobra too, but I kinda wanna save the Cobra, maybe. Well, no, I have no reason to save the Cobra, really. Yeah. Probably I'm going low in health when he still has some damage on the board. So it kinda depends on what kind of cards he has. If he has some good cards there, this may be a lost game to me. I can play Maligosson next turn, but it's not like he does anything for me.
What to do?
Except being like a 4/12 minion. I'm basically offering him a board clear here. And he kinda has to take the trade since neither of these are cards you would really want to leave on the board.
I wonder.
So, what will he do? At least he doesn't seem to have any easy choices here. He isn't instantly playing something.
You know, take
care. Okay, that does not really scare me that much. What are the 2 other cards there then? He got shapeshift. Will he just go for me? No, he hits the... Is this the swipe? Oh, this is the swipe, okay. And he swiped me? Would it have not been better to swipe my... Well, the problem is I have no way of getting rid of this, so I'm dead next turn unless I get something that stops it. So... Oh, Shieldmaster. Based Shieldmaster will keep me possibly alive for one more turn. Oh, he's running out of cards, but I'm running out of health. I don't know. Kind of depends on what is the better spot to be. If he's getting crap cards, then it's a pretty horrible spot to be, since you'll just see your... Okay. And that's well played then. He can kill me now. He has 6 damage on his hero power and these two dudes here. Well played. And he can just wipe. Did I not lose some druid with two swipes at the end on some of my videos? I seem to recall I did. Well, that wasn't quite the same. Well, it was pretty similar, I see. Hit me with both of the swipes. Anyway, well, that was a loss. I don't know if I could call that really a tight game. I guess he was pretty much in control from the start to the end. Nothing much I could have done there. I'm getting the feeling that this was not the best mage deck. I mean, screw those legendaries. Had I gotten just more fireballs or flame strikes, I would be much happier than with the Maligos and Alexstrasza. And Alexstrasza could kinda save you, but... Oh, another druid.
I must protect the wild.
You asked for it.
Yeah, I don't really want this, nor even the ogre. Let's give me something. Okay. Spell power. It does very little to me, still. Cone of Cold. Well, Cone of Cold Maligos would be a pretty sweet 6 damage spell there. Not well played, but
hello?
Greetings. Yeah. He does nothing. I get my second polymorph. I'll play the Brewmaster. I want a minion on the board. And I don't think I have that many Battlecry minions to pull back anyway. Oh, this is an annoying thing. Should I kill it or should I leave it be? If he has something like some one damage spell, it's not 2 damage spell, but what one damage spell could a druid have? Is my question. Moonfire? But I don't think many people draft Moonfire. So I will in fact just attack him. And he'll do the trade, okay. And he'll just shapeshift. I guess he doesn't have anything really to play, just like me. So how about some lower level stuff? Okay, that's fine. It's not like druids can get weapons anyway. Good thing at least is that I have my sheeps here, but it's kind of a... Kind of a good question if I should be saving the sheeps for big things, which probably have at the end game. Definitely will not be saving a sheep here. That's definitely something I want, sheep. And I'll just kill it with my Swamboos. Since druids do have some buffs on them. Their cards, so...
I've got a hit.
Okay, I think I may want to go out with the Venture Co here. I could freeze that dude. But what would freezing him do? Yeah, I'll go out with the Venture Co. Probably the safer bet. And this dude could be good if you had like some ice lances on you, but I don't, and they are kinda... not the best cards to draft if you don't have any kind of a... Okay, he starfires and... And then trades? Yeah, okay, that was like the best... Venture Co you would have hoped for, since he just blew two cards on him. A big removal too. Yeah, I mean, I think I just go Ogre Magi and a Ghoul. And Kono Cold does 2 damage now. Funny how we have gotten to high manas far faster than the previous game where he just had so much things to play. My opponent Druid. This guy has huge amount of cards but isn't playing much. Probably just like me in the last game. Yeah, I think that dude is a worthwhile sheep. Problem is next turn is 8 mana turn, and if he has one of those big goddamn trees, this might be a bad thing to use a sheep on.
What to do?
Let's check on sheep and then do one other thing. I kinda dislike. I should just kill it with this dude and hit him with 4 damage. Would be waste of 4 damage otherwise. No, will a big tree come out? If a big tree comes out, I can actually kinda handle it. Yeah, Ironbark Protector is the name, of course, of the tree dude. If not, I will probably play Malygos. Where shall I stay? Yeah, depending what he does with these 3 last manas. Thinking of playing something. Is that just 1-1? No, it's just giving him a new card. Oh, I could send in here too. I think Court of Cold Sengin is maybe the better play here. I would love to be able to play Malygos and 10 Cone of Cold, but that would not be the optimal play here. Then again, I'm gonna have to throw this guy away then if I Cone of Cold this. Let's see, if I play Malygos, what does he do? He'll trade, he'll kill the Ogre and then and kill that dude then. Yeah, I think Cone of Cold is a better play here from me. Drop this guy, and in my opinion, I'll trade with this dude. It would have made some sense to trade with the ogre too, since it would have made the ghoul far stronger. But the ghoul only had 2 health, and I think druid may well have a way to remove it. 4 health would need a direct. Okay, here comes Wild Pyromancer. Let's see if he had. Yeah, he could have easily killed. Have easily killed that ghoul, so it was a correct play. Okay. Let's think about this. I will probably face this manipulate Malygos. But I kinda wanna ping here. Ping this dude down. If I play Malygos, what could I do? Then I guess I would sacrifice this 1-1 to kill this guy. And you know what? I'll play Malygos. This guy kills this dude, and I'll just leave the ooze on the table. Four 12 with lots of spell damage, so he must be terrified about what kind of spells I may have in my hand now. I don't think I have played my Frostbolt yet, so that's the one thing I have. Okay, he'll just trade with the shield, that makes sense. Healing touches himself, that ain't gonna do anything but just slow me down a bit. That's a bad play for him, since I can just trade with Malygos. He claws, and I guess he kills the 4-1. Yeah, he's in a bad spot now. I'll get my own Azure Drake so I can copy this dude. I should have probably played Azure Drake first, but I can now play Azure Drake and I have like, what? 11 spell damage on the board. That's pretty hilarious. Two Maligosis. Yeah, that's a pretty... bit of a crazy board, I would say. I wonder if he thought I had something like a Pyroblast in my hand. The truth was I had nothing really in spells in my hand, but that probably looks like a pretty terrifying board. 11 spell damage there. Anyway, this was Ukko playing Hearthstone Arena. Until next time.